Maine recently became the second state to boot you-know-who off the ballot. They cited the same constitutional amendment. I'm going to say that again. The same constitutional amendment that Colorado did, which states that anyone who engages in insurrection is ineligible to run for political office. Okay? That's what the Constitution says. But now you know who is vowing to appeal, and some of his Republican rivals for the nomination think he should be allowed to stay in the race. Take a look.
The idea that one bureaucrat in an executive position can simply unilaterally disqualify someone from office, that turns on its head every notion of constitutional due process that this country's always abided by for over 200 years. It opens up Pandora's box.
Makes him a martyr. You know, he's very good at playing poor me, poor me. This should be decided by the voters of the United States. It should not be decided by courts.
Now, you remember, none of this would be happening had he let the people decide who they wanted to be president. Mm-hmm. He didn't like that. He didn't want that. And he has spent all of this time fighting that and saying that it, you know, it was a lie, it was this, it was that. He's been tossed out all over the place. Yeah. And now suddenly they're paying attention to the law. Where's everybody been? Did you just wake up and go, oh, damn? I mean, what do you think? What's going to go on here? Because they say it's going to be up to the U.S. Supreme Court to decide if the Constitution does indeed bar him from running. Even though the Constitution says, listen, if you do this you kind of stuff, run. You can't run. But apparently we always have to recheck with this fool, because every time he does something, they say, oh, well, they didn't mean him.
But I mean, did mean him.
Yeah, speak you know, to this. Speak it. Speak to him.
I'm going to speak to
it, girl.
It.
Speak it.
You know, the thing is, this is black letter constitutional law, and the Section 3 of the 14th Amendment basically says if you participated in an insurrection against this country, you may not hold office. You may not do it.
Say and that some one more people, time.
You
and
may
tell
not.
Them where it came from. Jefferson it, Davis.
Jefferson Davis.
Right.
Because it's about the Civil War, and they did not want anyone who tried to really take over this country by force to be able to hold office ever again. That is what our framers want, right? There's this argument out there that's like, but he wasn't convicted of anything. Jefferson Davis participated in an insurrection against the U.S. in 1861, and he became ineligible to run for president. By the way, he was not convicted of that. And so that argument is off the table. The other argument that should be off the table, it's going to go to the Supreme Court, but there are four justices that said, claimed to be originalists, textualists, meaning what was written in the Constitution at that time is the law that continues. I believe differently. I believe that the Constitution is a living and breathing document. They don't believe that. So if that is the case, on the floor, when they were debating it, someone said, let me call the senator's attention to the words of hold any office, civil or military, under the United States. That means the president who held an office cannot be on the ballot because he was involved. But and not only involved in insurrection, he caused that insurrection.
Yes, that's true. He is the leader of the pack.
He caused it.
According to what Christie just said, it will make him a martyr. So we have to decide, do we want a martyr or a felon? Those are our choices, basically.
Yeah.
And last time we left this up to the voter, the voters, he decided that he didn't want to do that. So the same thing is going to happen again. Yeah. So I say follow the law. Follow the law.
Well, if it was anybody,
they would have done it. Well, but the thing is, the law says this is what, and I love the constitutionalists, because if in fact we were living with a constitution that does not grow, and I had this conversation years ago, then you're saying, okay, so slavery is not gone anywhere. We haven't changed anything. There's a lot of stuff in the
Women don't have the right to vote.
Yeah. That's right. Women don't have the right to vote. Mm-hmm. So it is always evolving
it's
and changing.
Living and
it is a
document.
Living
well,
document.
Someone would then say they'll make amendments. I think the argument for originalists would be the amendments become part of that written law.
And
I believe
by the way,
interpretation,
this is an amendment.
Yeah.
Right, but I would say like the difference is people that agree, because I agree with you, Sunny, I believe it's a living document, that I would view the Second Amendment differently than it tends to be viewed by pro majorly pro-Second Amendment people, which is that they were planning a little more on a musket than an AR-15.
Yeah.
But what I would say
well,
here is...
Well, Scalia did that.
Yeah. But personally, I think he definitely engaged in an insurrection, and I look forward to him being convicted, rightly so. But I think even more so, the language says if you aid and comfort insurrectionists. And from the day he came out of the White House, he said, we love you. Go home.
That's such a great point.
Yeah, and then he also, and then in the video when he
good people on both sides.
He would pardon the, this is specific to the insurrectionists.
Oh, yes.
He said he would pardon the insurrectionists. He listened to their album from prison, because I guess it was a thing. So I think that, but the point I would say here is that I actually agree with Governor Gavin Newsom and David Axelrod. These are Democrats, leading Democrats, that say this would really cause a division that's almost insurmountable. And as someone that believes January 6th was that bad,
So what are you saying?
Just 1 second. I don't think the Supreme Court's gonna hold this. I think they're gonna overturn it, and it won't just be the originalists. I bet it's a 9-0 vote. I actually don't think they will hold this.
So you think they should leave it to the voters or not?
I think they should leave it to the voters, I think the division this will cause, because what will happen is that martyrdom will be one step more. We have a nation that doesn't believe in democracy, doesn't believe in the voting. Everyone that loses says it was rigged and failed. I think this will create a vision, a visual to people that don't, that this was a rigged election by doing it. I do.
I think that the law will stand and people should follow the law.
If that is the law the Supreme Court
does. If you're not going to follow an amendment, then why don't we have Taylor Swift run for president?
I don't think it's as clear
perspective than the martyrdom. I'm very conflicted on this as a conservative because I tend toward being more of an originalist. I worry about two things. When we look at the law, you think of the precedent that it sets. So say that this ends up holding. Donald Trump becomes, if he, God forbid, becomes president about this time next year, he could weaponize that same ruling to keep Democrats off the ballot. In the same way that he says Joe Biden is a threat to democracy, he's going to say this Democrat engaged in insurrection.
This is what I mean. It's going to be off the ballot.
So then we're operating from a place of fear.
Because if he has secretaries of state or he has appointed judges that he appointed who are loyal to him, they will weaponize the same decision. And one more thing. Democracy.
Pretty sure the Democrats aren't going to start a January 6th insurrection.
But the problem is it'll be based on their definition and interpretation is my fear. My second thought here is democracy is very fragile right now. A third of Americans, Republicans, don't believe the last election was legitimate, even though it was.
I was going to say, you believe.
I believe it was legitimate. My fear here is this will, for the first time, they will be able to say, I cast my vote for Donald Trump and the system threw it out, and then it will actually be true.
You're then saying that people are so dumb that they won't recognize that when you say, you know, I cast my vote and they threw it out, that there is a symbiosis in here.
And they don't.
And the fact that he is not, this wasn't like, oh, we're saying you can't vote for this, but we're not gonna keep him on there because we don't like him. No, this is the law.
But there's so little trust is the problem. And listen.
Yes, but you know what? At what point does fear take over? Because if you're afraid to make the laws stick, then there's no point in having them.
And if it's that clear, the Supreme Court will decide it.
I think that's true. I think
so. You know?
Yeah.
Well, and the problem with the Supreme Court, because they have said that they were traditionalists and originalists, and they lied.
They're
a
liars.
Lot of them lied.
Gorsuch.
Will it change your opinion, though, if Clarence Thomas, nine of them vote this Alito, down as unconstitutional?
And who's the other one? There's four of them. Gorsuch, Alito, Amy.
Kavanaugh.
And Kavanaugh.
And so they have lied. And so that is a concern for me. But that does not change the fact that that is the law.
They went on television and said that Roe v. Wade was established law, and they still overturned it. So I don't trust them at all.
I mean, and final point, we are only even having this unprecedented conversation that literally hasn't been discussed since the Civil War because
of
Donald Trump's
unprecedented insurrection started by Donald
J. Trump.
Legal.
I have a legal note.
Yeah, she knows.
Trump has denied any wrongdoing regarding January 6th. He has also denied wrongdoing in state and federal criminal cases
and has pleaded not guilty to approximately over 90 charges.
Nine.